What's up, everybody? Welcome to the 280th day, Make It Songbringer. Just the days fly by. Today I'm going to be working on finishing up these last... For so long, I've left the game in this state where you couldn't freeze enemies with your top hat, with your frozen top hat, and there's a lot of unfinished items. The fire top hat, the poison top hat, and all these other items and stuff that you can create by combining. Oh damn, that just broke. What's up, Arcane? Welcome. What's up, Pedro? Yeah, I just noticed a little bug right quick. So this needs to be crash 4, 8, 12. I was working on this earlier. This is where so there's four different scout bikes that go out at the very beginning of the game. And so you're one of the scouts. There we go, okay. That time it worked. So you can actually find your friends' bikes, and also you're also gonna be able to find them actually as NPCs. So they all crash too, and they wander off looking for stuff. And you find them eventually. Okay. What's up, Alex Beta? So, the next items I want to finish up are the ghost swords. For a while, they've been in this state where they're really weird. They, like, when I shoot them, it's like it doesn't do the proper animation. In fact, let's slow down time really slow. See what's going on. So there's that last frame is really weird. Flashes. So I'll figure that out. Also, I want to be able to shoot them diagonally. Oh, it didn't work. What's up, Rocket Bunny? Get your chocolate milk? There we go. There's one going diagonal. So I want those to have diagonal art as well. First thing to figure out here is why they are doing that weird flash at the end. I want to look at these frames for the ghost sword. Start with just this east animation here. This must be east 5. Yeah. And then East 4. Let's get the info out. So opacity on these is like 90, 60, 30. And then for this last frame, it's 60, 90, 30, same thing. Okay, so the frames are okay. You're early, nice, right on. Thanks, horniest of men. All right, I guess it must be something to do with how the ghost sword is rendered or is animated. So I guess I'll start with input system where it actually launches the ghost sword. Here's where it launches. It delays, and then it launches, starting the shot. Here's the fear sword, ice sword. Damn, by the way, what sword am I even using here? This is the lightning sword. Okay, lightning sword. It adds the collision flag lightning. Animates lightning sword particles. Or it's supposed to. I don't know if it's done this in a minute. So when a function says static void, what does the static part mean? And the void part. Okay. These are two totally different parts. The void is the return type. Okay. So functions return values, right? Like integer, string, you know. There's no string, actually. There's no actual string type, but integer, float, you know, all those things are return types. Void just means it's returning nothing. Void is like it's returning nothing. Not even a single byte. And then static has different meanings, but when you're creating a static function inside of a CPP file, it just means that that function, or that, yeah, it just means that this function can only be used inside this CPP file. When you're using it with in a header file, if you're doing a static function, it means that that function, or I mean, if this is part of a class. If you're using it as part of a class or a structure, that means that you can only use that function statically. That means it can't access any member data. If this had member data, like if input system had an integer current input component or whatever like that, these static methods would not be able to access that member function. But they could access static data. So let me show you, like world, for example. Let's go to world's header file. World has a whole bunch of static methods because all of it accesses this one static right here. Static world. So the world creates all, you know, the world contains all this data. And then the static is a copy of the whole world as one static member variable so that every one of these functions here can access the world data, but it's all statically. You really got to read up to understand it more. What am I talking about? I'm talking about code, man. I'm making a game here. What language is this? It's called C++. What's up, Jules? What's up, Scottish Pizza? Welcome, everybody. Okay, so I'm working on the ghost sword here. And I don't know what happened, but a long time ago, something broke in the ghost sword. First of all, it doesn't leave a trail anymore. It's supposed to leave a trail of particles. And secondly, it does this weird flashing. So I'm working on these, and also I want them to be able to do diagonal, so I'll have diagonal frames for these. Hey, Rocket Bunny, I was having a thought about that, about you, about your dad. Why does he not want you to program? Have you understood that yet? Have you really talked to him about why it is that he doesn't want you to program? Because maybe in finding out what his reasons are, you might find something, you might find a solution there. Okay, let's see about lightning sword particles. What if I don't even do this? I wonder if it'll change. So you haven't asked him why. Okay, this might be your next step. You know, if you can understand why it is your dad. Oh, okay. So maybe you haven't tried it. Yeah, if you can understand that, I think it could help you a lot. You know? Because we might be making some assumption here, or you might be making an assumption here. Somebody might be assuming something. So if you really just talk to them about that, you get rid of your assumptions and you can clarify the whole situation. All right, so did that change anything, doing this lightning sword particles? Like it. No. Okay, so that didn't change anything. Let's make sure this also has lightning that comes down and hits enemies. Scottish Pizza Quexler, that was like 2010. Horniest of men, I'm interacting with everyone here. What's up, man? What do you want to know? All right, so let's try and attack some enemies here. Man, what is all this? Wow. We got, you want my address? Here's some enemies, dang. Yeah, that's not even enlightening. No wonder. Oh, wait a minute. What if are there two, perhaps two different? Oh, there's the problem. We have a ghost sword and a lightning sword. Well, that's starting to make sense. Looks like we might have a troll today. All right, well, let's go attack another enemy and see what's up. Oh, there, now we have lightning sword particles at least. That's good. What do I want for Christmas? Actually, what I want is a blues. I want this brass blues slide so I can play blues guitar. That's something I want. Your soul. I wonder if that's had some, if that's why. That's why it's doing this weird flickering thing. Let's make sure the player doesn't have any other swords. Got sword, fire sword 0, lightning sword 1, ghost sword 0. Let's put all these right by each other too. And let's also add the ice sword. So we just know. Seriously, horniest of men, you're kind of being you're acting like a troll. I'm not saying that because of your name. So if you're gonna keep on trolling us, I'm gonna ban you. So either be nice and participate in the conversation like a nice person, or else I'm definitely gonna ban you. All right. Okay. Fire sword, ghost sword, lightning sword, ice sword. You want a raspberry pea? Nice. Or a raspberry pie. I call it raspberry pea every time. Yeah, those look fun. Have you heard of Game Kid? Right, we definitely need a place on the world that is friendly for fighting enemies. This will do. Okay, so two things. First thing I want to do is work on that flicker. It's really weird. Yeah, I'm gonna give him a second. I'm gonna give him a second. Let's try some other swords to see if maybe the ice sword or something doesn't flicker. Yeah, I agree with you, Horny Cement. You are a viewer like everyone else, but just be nice, all right? Check that again. Ice sword, does it flicker? Yeah, figure this out, this flicker. What is this? So in start shot, type is the type of shot. Let's go look at the ghost sword. Actual attributes and everything. We got additive. We also have oh, flash. That's it. It's flashing. Right, sorry, man. Dude, I'm banning you. Sorry, but if you want to message me, you can try and join this stream again later. But for now, we're having too much troubles with you, so I'm gonna ban you, dude. So now, oh good, good, good. Now it's not flickering anymore. Yay. This is how it's supposed to look. Cool. There is a bug when you kill frozen enemies. That's one thing. Okay, next thing I want is so the ghost swords. So this should not definitely not flash. But additive is cool. Thanks, Pedro. All right. Oh yeah, so the way that the top hat is thrown, it's got this cool effect where if you are holding a diagonal direction, then you can throw it in a diagonal direction, but if not, it forces you to be only four directions. So I'm gonna do the same thing with the ghost sword. So you have to actually be holding a diagonal direction in order to throw a diagonal ghost sword. Sergeant Sam, how does it work with threads? Does every object have its own thread? No, definitely not. No. Multi-threading. This game does use multi-threading, but not actually my game. The Cocos 2DX engine uses multi-threading. Like it'll have a separate thread for rendering, separate thread for sound. Sometimes you have a separate thread for loading data, stuff like that. But you know, you're not usually a game does not have a separate thread per object. That would really be overkill. I hope that helps, man. A little research into that topic, and I think you'll definitely start understanding a little more how threads work too. Okay. No, don't be sorry for asking questions. What are threads? Threads are something a pro modern day pro think of, threads are, let me draw it like this. Modern day processors are like multi-threading evolved because of having only a single processor. You know, back in the day, we only had a single processor. So imagine threads like this. Imagine a circle with spokes, right? And each one of these things is a thread. A thread is just a bit of code that's running, okay? So what happens is at CPU tick number zero, it does this tick. At CPU tick number one, it does this. It runs a little bit of this thread. So during each one of these thread runs, it goes and runs like maybe 10 different CPU instructions for that thread. So it runs a little bit of this code, it runs a little bit of this code, it runs a little bit of this code, and then it runs a little of that code, that code, that code, that code, until it gets all the way back to the first thread, where it runs a little bit more of that thread, and then it runs a little bit more of that thread, and that thread, and that thread. See what I mean? It just keeps going around and around and around and around, running more and more code for each one of the, for each one of the threads. That's when we only had one CPU. Today we have multiple cores, but still works the same way. Multi-threading runs a little bit of code on each core. Hope that helps. Scottish Pizza, do I have any books I can recommend? It sucks because the book I learned from doesn't exist anymore, but I would recommend books on game programming. To be honest, I haven't read any of the latest game development or game programming books. All I can recommend is learn code the hard way. I would learn C the hard way if I were you. So C.learn code the hard way. I've heard is good. I haven't actually read this book, but I've heard this one's good. So sorry I don't have any better recommendations, but I would just say, search it out, look for some good books, see which ones you resonate with too. Read a little bit of the book and then go, is this something I'm actually going to finish, Just find a book that you like, and that's probably better than any recommendation I could give you. It's all good. Sensibility. All right, so the top hat, here we go. This is where this sets it to be only four directions if standing still. All right, I'm going to make a simple function which guess we'll do it like this, only four directions if. Pass in a boolean and a direction to start with. Oh, at first you thought threads were variations of strings, huh? Yes, so that's what threads are in the real world, exactly. So this is going to pass in a compositor and also a boolean. So if the boolean, oh this, if not boolean, no. Yeah, if boolean, there, it locks it down to four directions. Okay, so now we can apply this to both these methods of launch go sword and launching the top hat. So we'll go this. Only four directions if we pass in E move last compositor, and then the boolean is this E position pause equals last position means they haven't moved. There. And now we can do the same thing with the launching of the go sword. Where did we grab the direction? Oh, here it is. Get attacked her. Oh, get attacked her. Actually, oh man, this is smarter. If I were to go and make build this into the get attacked her function, it's probably be better. Because we already got the entity and everything. So let me take a look at all the functions that call get attacked her first. Only two of them right here. Oh, totally. Yeah, okay, so this whole function, only four directions if, blah, 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 can totally be part of getAttackedHer. So we get the current, we get the direction, and then only four directions if standing still. E position dot pause equals E dot position dot last pause. Then the direction gets clamped to only four. There. Okay, so all right, very good. Now back here, Scotch Pizza Wizard. I'm going to work on a 2D race game. Sweet. What kind of car do you drive? I don't actually have a car. I know it's a weird question, but I just wanted to add your car in. That's cool. Thanks, Scotch Pizza. That's so cool. You know what? You know what I would pick if I had, if I were to pick a car. Let me show you the car. This is like my dream car, all right? But if I owned a car, I would own a Jeep Scout 2, and I would totally make it electric. So there's a Jeep Scout 2. It's kind of like a Bronco. But yeah, if you want to make an Easter egg car for me, this one right here with the orange and the white stripes would be perfect. That's a cool question, man. And I'm stoked to play your game. Here we go. Now this is much simpler. I don't need to do this only four directions thing. But I do need to apply this. Nice, right on. I'm glad you love it. You apply this here. All right. Okay, now just to make sure all this works. Oh, also we want to get rid of this only four directions if function. Cool, C++, right on, man. Hopefully Jonathan Blow will release Jai soon enough so we can all use that too. Be sweet. Okay, so I should be able to, okay, if I move to the diagonally and then throw the top at. Yeah, it's all good. But if I'm actually moving in a diagonal direction, I could throw in a diagonal direction. Yeah. Cool. All right, great. Now let's test that out with the ghost sword. So if I move in a diagonal direction, use the sword. Yeah, good. All right, great. It's working quite well. I like that. I think I want the particles to be bigger now. Cool. Collision response, right on. It's fun. I like that phase of game development. All right, so I sort particles. I want these to be twice the size. In fact, let's make all of these bigger. Maybe even four. Heck, let's live large. One shifted up, or two shifted up, DRAND, two. There, so that will be two, either two or four. Yeah, exactly what we want. Let's see that with bigger particles. You always just save the old position, and if the rectangle link overlaps one of the walls, you set the old position. Oh, okay. That works if you're only moving it like a pixel at a time. You know, sometimes if you're moving, say, 5 pixels per frame, you might want to only move 3 of those pixels. So there's your answer, Jules, that if that's good or not. It's only good if you're moving a pixel at a time. Vakus, what's up? Give you some motivation for coding? Here you go, man. Here's a game I've been working on for a year. And I've been coding it. Can code something too. There, now we got bigger particles. These look a lot better. Alright. But I think they should be... Actually, one shifted up, DRAND 3. And more of them. Man, I want more of these for sure. So Jules, you might want to try like incremental. So take your current system, right? And all you got to do is move 1 pixel at a time. So let's say you want to move Link by 5 pixels per frame, right? You want to go just loop over those 5 pixels and do your same algorithm 5 times. Are you getting me? You break your collision detection up into iterations. Okay, so the problem with this is it's putting lots of these particles on top of each other. That's because it's using the position.pause plus spec2.0. Oh, this is the entity's current position. Yeah, so we should do some randomness here. Something like DRAND F times 2 at least, maybe 4. What's up, Zanger? And Pema, what's up, Pema? Welcome, everybody. You're pulling an all-nighter? That's a little better. Let's do a little more, actually. Maybe 8 even. Is there a level in EXP system in Songbringer? No, there's not. And that's purposeful. Yeah. It's meant to be like Zelda. Zelda never has experience points or levels or any of that stuff. While I love that, concept in RPGs, it was really hard for me to not put it in this game, actually. These are starting to look better. For each axis, check if the position where the player will be next frame collides with anything. If so, set player position on current axis to closest position possible without colliding. Yeah. There you go. Some more suggestions for you there, Jules. Oh, thanks, Rocket Buddy. I'm sure there's other RPGs you like. Or do you just not like RPGs? Is that your thing? You prefer other kind of games? Next thing, wait, let's get some sweet sound effects going for this. Or should I? No, I guess I need to do the diagonal move. Diagonal. Okay, yeah, let's do some diagonal sword action. So we've got a ghost sword launch. I think we can go. Yeah, we need like a northeast and a southeast as well. So I'm gonna go ahead and save out two versions of this. Ghost sword launch. Northeast and southeast. Open those both back up. Here's the northeast one. We got the southeast one. Whoops. I don't know what that one is. Southeast, northeast, and we should also have east open. Just for that shits and giggles. All right, so northeast. I'm just gonna basically rotate this a little bit. XPixel, are you asking me? Are you asking those guys? But if you're asking me, no, I'm not using any kind of quad trees, but I am optimizing it by pre-looking up all of the components that have collision detection for certain filter types before each frame. So each frame, it goes and lists all the current collision components, and that makes it really, really fast to run this really simple collision system. Okay, so let's draw some more frames. Let's draw this up. Get this moving in a northeast, nor'easter. All right, you watched the first episode? Yeah. Yeah, Boxhoodie is. Boxhoodie, and also has Boxhoodie has kind of like these weird little glitches. Like, you can get entities to kind of like, if you're right on a certain corner, for example, you can like fall through things and stuff. Like, you really got to be really, any physics or collision engine you use is going to have its quirks. So you either write your own and your own's going to have its own quirks, or you use somebody else's and that thing's going to have quirks. So just recognize that physics engines are quirky. I've never used a physics engine that's not. Yeah, and the units are weird too. Yeah. Pema, I just do only rectangles. Yeah. But I can do small rectangles and stuff like that. But in the past, I've done collision detection as ellipses before. I've also done collision detection as polygons. So I've done all types of collision detection, except for I've never done pixel perfect before. In fact, if I were to do Maybe for Songbringer 2, I'll do Pixel Perfect. Because I really am attracted to Pixel Perfect. But for now, this works okay. Added in a little bit of pathfinding so that if you're moving, for example, north and you hit something you're colliding with, it keeps walking in a west or east direction. So it walks smoothly. So I'm happy enough with this rectangular collision detection as it is. What's SAT collision detection? Separate axis theorem. Oh, so is that kind of what you were describing earlier there? About moving one axis at a time? I should really check this out later on. If a line separating two convex polygons can be drawn, the polygons do not collide. Oh, okay. That's interesting. That's so great because with polygons, there's so many rad tricks to do polygon math so fast. Have I heard of Heartbeast? No, what's that? CodePix3, do I have any resources for learning pixel art? Sorry, I don't, but there are some great ones online. You know, check out Pixel Junk, or not Pixel Junk, but just do pixel art tutorials. Google this. There's so many great ones. Here's a great one from Honkyat. This first result, 30 excellent pixel art tutorials. Check these out. Okay, so I want to draw some diagonal frames. Let's add a grayish background so I can see this thing. All right, so on this frame, I want to rotate it a little. What's up, Boogie? Oh yeah, there's that too. 435? Dang, nice. Okay, I mean, this is just rotated a little, I guess. Wait, what? How many degrees do I want to go? Not quite 45. Shoot, I gotta do math. What? Okay, so I wanna get. How do you calculate? How do you calculate the number of degrees the angle of a triangle? Oh, nice. Look at this. Oh, thank you, Google. Okay, so the A side is I want the H. I want to specify the H, man, not the A. All right. Well, okay. Let me just draw a new picture here. Here's my triangle. Whoa, you got a Commodore 64 with the 400 games? Nice. Right. The Pythagorean theorem is gonna what I'm gonna use here just to get the height right here. So if my length is 1, my height is gonna be 0.707. So I need to calculate this number right here. So 1 squared plus 0.7 squared square root is gonna give me that other angle. 1 squared is 1, 0.707 squared is that. Square root of that is gonna be 1.224. Okay, so there's my length of A. B is 1. Area? I need to know the area. Damn it. This is lame. I'm just gonna guess. What's up, Reagan Knight? I know, nobody told me there was gonna be math today. Wait, 1 over 2b times h? Is that it, x pixel? Yes, I just used Pythagorean's theorem to get the other side. 1 over 2b times the height. Let's try that. So the height is 1 over 2b. B is the other edge. Wait, hold on. B is the un oh, that edge. So 1 over 2 times 1. Songbird is canceled. Is it for gamma? No, it's not a 90 degrees. It's something less than 90. It's like point. Hell, maybe I can just do 90 times 0.707. So let's do 63 degrees. That'll be roughly correct. And then I can see it in the game and see if it's not. No, I'm just trying to get the angle so I can rotate this thing. And not quite rotated. Oh, it's not 45. It's or not 90. It's 45 times 0.707. This is probably wrong, but it'll be close enough. 31 degrees. So there. 31. This is about what the angle should be. Not quite 45. Look how messed up that looks. But it'll work. Sorry, I don't mean to scare y'all. Don't be scared, it's gonna be okay. I don't even really need my pen yet, but I guess once I touch these pixels up, then we'll need to do something. With the pen. Pen is much mightier than the sword. Everybody knows that, right? Coding math. Yes, no, for sure. Every programmer needs this. Okay, these pixels are really junky, but it doesn't matter. I'm just going to export this thing, render it. Need to put this in the common folder. Launch northeast. That's good. Okay, so now the ghost sword itself. Well, what's that? Ghost sword. Entity here needs launch animations for northeast and southeast. Top 10 games of 2015? Man, I only got one. Axiom Verge is my favorite game of 2015. I played a lot of other games, but they're really not my top games, I would consider. Axiom Verge is right up there because I just loved it. Loved it. All right, so now we got Northeast. Okay. So now we just need to be able to run that animation. Switch back into code mode for a minute. Yes, it's a lot like Metroid, but not Vania. Not like Castlevania, it's a lot like Metroid though. And it's awesome. Just Cause 3? No, I haven't. Looks awesome. This is definitely the kind of game I would play. It's like action. It looks like I'm playing an action movie. Which I watch these anyways, right? Look, he's got a squirrel suit. Oh, it's awesome. Wow. AAA games are freaking awesome, aren't they? Full of explosions. Yeah, Scottish Pizza, you could probably do that. You could probably give away a free copy somehow. All right, here when we're launching a shot, we've given it the direction. Oh yeah. Okay, there's get a nim key. Oh, yeah. Okay, let's try this out. If we add in a clause for Northeast, let's see if this works. Let's see if that worked. C'est la vie. Are you even allowed to play it? Nismo, can you show me your collision template? You're talking to me? I'll show you the collision for the game. There's the collisions areas. All these red areas are collisions. Okay, so if I move to the northeast, yeah, it worked. But the only thing it didn't work is that the player now stopped his swing because that he didn't have a northeast animation for this. So I think what needs to happen is if we fall through and we haven't done any of this, then we need to just do. Yeah, we need. Basically, this should all be string streams. I'm thinking instead of strings, let's do a string stream. Wait, can you take out characters from a string stream? Oh, I missed the BC Warrior. What's up, BC Warriors? How do I make Jib fly around smoothly? He just has an angle. Instead of everybody else has 8 compass directions, but Jib has 360 degrees. That's it. At any given moment, he can be heading in any one of those directions. But once again, there's no sines or cosines needed. Can you take away? Can you take away from a string stream? Yeah. Looks like the only solution is to start over with a new string. That sucks. All right. Maybe better to not do it that way. Maybe string ret and then ret.reserve. Wait, we do have a reserve, right? Key.size plus possibly 2 more characters. And then ret equals key. I think that should start it off to be a little better there. Yeah, Rocket Bunny, all vectors are is just a variable that contains 2 or 3 or 4 variables, you know, like you're just accessing the X anyways. I agree, I think AI is totally fun. Behavior trees have really changed everything. Get line? No, I'm not. I don't need to use get line. I'm writing to the string. I'm not reading from it. Okay, so if I add ret plus equals n. Oh, okay, I get it now. Basically, if we get this far, we want to reset the key. So ret equals key. This is trying out a whole bunch of things. Oh, and this might be up to 3 characters, actually. Oh my God. Oh, wait. This is supposed to be trying that. Dang. I guess I could do this. This kind of sucks, though. I guess we need like a base. Base is reserving maybe just plus one. Yeah. And here, okay, so this is. Here we get the base. So base equals key, and then base plus equals two, and then here's where we're going to fall back to red equals base. Actually, all these need to be red equals base. I think that's right. Man, this is a really complex method. It's basically just trying to ferret out which animation to use. Oh, there's no help with AI. Yeah. AI is something, yeah, there's different ways to implement it too. If it's tough for you, just practice it a bit, you know? Yeah, Rocket Bunny's true. Yeah, you are all influencing Songbringer. Totally. You totally are. There's no doubt about that. I know, my phone. What's up with my phone? You're like, check it, check it. But I'm from the 80s, man. From the 70s, actually. So back then, we didn't check our phones. We didn't have phones. He's still getting stuck. Damn it. After all that. Nice. Maybe you're texting me? Why would you be texting me when you can already chat? Right, I guess what we need to do is figure out what animation the player's running when he swings his sword. So for anybody who just joined the stream, what I'm doing here is I'm creating diagonal animations. And there's a little problem. So if I do a diagonal animation, the player breaks. Okay, let's break it down, figure out what's up. Input system, we start a shot for the ghost sword. Here we do that. And this will run animations on the player and everything. Yeah, good move, Scottish Pizza. Definitely start as small as you can. Scope your projects as small as you possibly can at first. Really. A lot of people's problems is they start with a really ambitious idea. They're like, man, I want to make the next, just like that, Grand Theft Auto or something. And they've never made a game before. And they start off and then they get super discouraged fast. So the thing is, you want to have very small games, very small successes, especially at first. And then later you can build up doing full-length games once you're accomplished and you're confident that you can. Okay, so we're starting a diagonal shot. Yeah, here we go. Here's up. Oh. Here we run the parents shoot animation. Right. This is where we want it. We're going into the player. If stance. Okay. We didn't add a 2 to that. What's this key? Key is shoot. We're not even running that. Oh, that's because the player already ran their animation. Oh, that's right. Okay, never mind. This is where we're launching the ghost sword. Right, okay. We actually want to go to where we're using the sword, because this is where, yeah, here it is. Here's where we're actually launching or running the animation. There. Oh yeah. Well yeah, sometimes you just gotta start even smaller then if you're, you know, if you feel like your stuff looks bad or whatever, start with stuff that is really simple, but it doesn't matter if it looks bad, you know? Don't think that was diagonal. Okay, start attack. Got a direction. Start timer. We got a new stance. Last compass direction. Here's where we run the animation. We've got melee, but we're adding a stance. Oh, that's right. Sometimes we have alternate stances here, and they've already been added. All right, so this first call to render NM key. This is what we need to pay attention to. So we got base, ret, both of those should be empty, right? Cool. Perfectionism is your worst attribute? Oh, Jules. Okay. I really want to help you here because I've always been that way too. I've always been a perfectionist about my games. What I learned a long time ago, though, was that you have to have lenience with yourself in how you do stuff. Okay, your perfectionism is, yes, it can be a hindrance if it stops you from making games, you know, or if it's stopping your certain idea. But it can also be an incredible attribute, a incredible, what do you call those? Positive thing. Perfectionism is, you know, it's positive and it's negative, right? If you're using it in a negative way, it is stopping you. Then it's going to be, you know, a bad thing. But your perfectionism is a really good thing for making awesome art. So once you become a little bit more of an artist, you start making more art, your perfectionism is going to help you so much. So just you got to learn how to use it. It's like a, I don't know, riding a bicycle or something. What's up, Protito? Okay, so base is equals key. Base is melee too. And here's where we're doing this. Oh, this is key equals idle. This is so bad. I definitely don't need to be doing that there. Oh, yeah, I guess I could be. This should be written like this, so it's a little more obvious at least. Whoops. Okay, so it didn't change that. If ret equals base, or ret equals base, we got melee 2. Last compaster equals northeast. This is gonna do this one. So we got ret equals northeast. It's ignore profile. Damn it. Maybe it shouldn't ignore profile for these diagonal directions. Or maybe it shouldn't even try. Yeah, maybe it shouldn't even try. So else if for not ignoring the profile. We can try for these diagonals. Yeah. Oh, sweet, it worked. And the angle worked out. We didn't even have to do any math. Yay. All right, let's see what it looks like with Southwest then. Southwest and all that. Okay. Let's do quick old. Before I make the pixels perfect, let's go and make some imperfect pixels. All right, so this time we're gonna rotate downward 31 degrees. And yeah, after this is all verified that it's working, I'll go and clean up the pixels a little bit just to make it look nice. All right, good. That was fast. All right, now we got southeast ones and should be rendering our frames and everything right now. And we launched southeast. Have I received any hate from people? Of course. Oh my god, some of the worst hate ever. I know you'd be surprised, right? And I was surprised too, man, but I'll tell you, I've got some of the worst hate ever. There was this one time on the stream, there was like the worst troll ever. He was really ragging on the game. He's like, "You procedurally generated games suck so bad. I'm such a dick." This guy was the worst dick ever. He was so bad. This guy kept, he was like thriving on his hatred. And he was so bad that he would, I would ban him, and then he would come back to life as a different name. He had like 8 or 9 different names. He kept on coming back and said, "You banned me, blah, 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 blah." Such a dick. He was the worst guy ever. And then I got tons of hate on Steam. Not tons of hate, I shouldn't say that. But I got a lot of hate on Steam. When you do Steam Greenlight, that's just gonna happen, you know? But when I did the math on the Steam Greenlight hate, here's what I realized. 98% of people had something positive to say. And in fact, a lot of it was really positive stuff. Like 98% of people said the best stuff ever. Like, "Whoa, this game's sweet." And then only 2% of people were the ones that gave that gave super hateful comments. And I realized then that, you know, the game that I'm writing is not for the people that hate it. You know, it's for the people that like it. So, basically, fuck those people. You don't need to worry. You don't even need to think about haters. Just to either ignore haters or delete their comments or whatever, because the game isn't even for them. You know, and focus on the positive, too. You got to focus on the 98% of people that have something positive to say about your game, rather than the 2% of people that are just haters. You know, and who cares why they hate? It just boggles my mind that people are such haters, but who cares why? It doesn't matter. It could be jealousy. Yeah, it could be jealousy. Who knows? Oh, we've got to hook up the Southeast Method. Oh, that's right. All right, so back in render system, let's try for southeast directions now. Southeast and southwest. This is going to be the southeast animation. Oh, and we don't need to worry about this ignore profile anymore, because these directional NMs. Yeah, Reganite, that's a good point. Criticism should only be constructive, not deconstructive. And that's the thing. If you get criticism from somebody and it is constructive, you got to thank that person, even if it hurts to hear it. You know, because constructive criticism is awesome. This whole game is based on constructive criticism. You guys watching saying, hey, I don't know if that's working. Try something else. Or people's comments on YouTube or whatever. I get tons of creative, constructive criticism, and it's awesome. And even if it hurts to hear it, you gotta thank those people. But then if you do get totally deconstructive, unhelpful criticism, then that's hate. Just categorize that in the hate factor and just ignore it. Don't worry about it. For example, one person recently hated my music. He's like, dude, I love your game, but I hate your music. Basically, that was his comment on YouTube. And I was like, okay, thanks. How can I improve my music? How would it be better? You know, how could, in your opinion, how would the music be better? But he never replied. So that's just basically unhelpful criticism. So, but it wasn't quite hate. I guess it was hate, in a way. Just a smaller hate, whatever. It's not something I would ban the guy for, or like, ignore him, or delete his comment, but still, it's unhelpful. It looks like this. Wait, did that work? Hold on. Slow down time. Yes. Oh, there. It gets to be a horizontal direction as soon as it hits something, it looks like. Crazy. Be release actually. Right, yeah, it's true. Yeah, some hate, that's the distinction you got to make. Some haters, if they're actually, they're kind of hating, but yet they are giving you constructive feedback, that's when you just got to realize the person might be having a bad day or whatever, but they are actually trying to help you. So then, you know, then you just got to, you know, it's just a, It's almost like you got to be good at psychology to be a game developer. You got to understand people and what they're trying to tell you sometimes. Nice, thanks, Rega. Okay, I think what it's doing is it's running a release animation. In fact, if the Ghost Sword had no release animations, would it still be doing that thing where it stops the animation? Okay, good. Yeah, okay, so it's definitely the release animation that was doing that. So we need release southeast and northeast as well. Okay, so I'm gonna open up those and we'll rotate those. Yes, feedback is one of the most important aspects of game development. Totally agree. And so is knowing how to take feedback. Just like what we've been talking about here with haters versus constructive criticism and all that. You got to know how to take feedback and take it in stride and thank people for it, you know? To be a big person about it all, even if a person's having a bad day and their criticism comes across as hate. You know, we gotta see past all that. Where's the release? Oh, what is the release animation? Here's launch. Oh. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, the release animation. Yay, I don't have to do anything else. Wait, what's this doing down there? Yeah, so this is okay. I could do a release northeast, southeast. But just reversing the northeast. And southeast is just a reverse of the launching southeast. Here we go. Firefox? Wait, what happened to Firefox? Oh, because of the JavaScript and all that? See what's going on. It's actually freezing the enemies while they're underneath the ground. Yeah, but it's not okay. It's working now. Great. Okay, we got northeast, southeast animations. I'm just gonna go touch these up a little bit and call this good. I don't even really need to touch that one. No one's interested in... Wait. Nice, right on, pizza. No one's interested in game development? In your school? That's really weird to me. Oh, there he goes. Personally, I would think that a lot more people would be interested in game development today than there were when I was a kid. But, you know, it just goes to show. So what are people interested in if they're not into game programming or, you know, other... You know, they might just not be creative people. Sup, why not? You just ran a mile? Nice. Oh, so they just play games, huh? Marketing or business? What? What? I guess that's, you know, that's some for some people that is their art, you know. Business can be an art form in a way. What are they interested in? Alcohol and drugs? Maybe. Generation of realists these days, huh? Really? Realists? Is that who the generation is that's growing up? McMonkey, what's up, McMonkey? Java, Flappy Bird. What? Not enough people signed up? Dude, I find that fascinating. I really would think that more people would be like super stoked about something as awesome as game development. You know, it's fun. It's like one of the most funnest jobs you could possibly have. Oh, see you, Rocket Bunny. Later, man. Yeah, remember to ask him why. There's really not that much to do to clean up these pixels. It's just like, it's more aesthetic than anything. I kind of like that one. You watched a cool part of a game theory stream? Uh-huh. So Scott Cawthon, is he the one that made Five Nights at Freddy's? Yeah. Okay, cool. It's great to have that. It's great to have your heroes, you know, in game development. Personally, one of my heroes is the guy that made Axiom Verge, Thomas Happ. He's one dude. He made all the music, all the art, and did all the code. And I respect that. I think it's freaking awesome. There's lots more of those kind of people out there today, though. Because game development has gotten easier and easier with so many great tools we got today. Okay, pixels are cleaned up. We can export these. Let's check them again. Make sure nothing broke in the process of exporting that art. Extra credits? You mean the guy that makes? Oh, whoops. Whoa, that's crazy. You worked at the dollar store? Rega, do I like climbing and running? Yes, both of those. A lot. I love climbing even more than running, but I do love running too. You found an old abandoned factory? Old climbable pipes? Oh, it's awesome! Oh, it's so rad. That's like my dream. I bet you we got that kind of stuff here too in Oakland. Bay Area. That's so awesome. Seriously, climbing things is one of my favorite things to do. Trees, I love climbing trees so much. My favorite kind of trees to climb are the ones with low branches, of course. Right, looks like all these directions are working good. Yeah, that's great. The art's looking good. Yes! We got diagonally moving di go swords. This is worth checking in. Stream field trip. Yay! I guess I could periscope something sometime. Spymort, what's up, man? All right, so anybody join the stream? Just to right now, I'm working on the ghost swords, and I just got them so they can launch diagonally. And I'm also gonna work on doing, if I got time, I'll do poison top hat today. Wait, what did I just add that didn't work? Ghost sword launch, raw sheets, common ghost sword launch. Oh. Right. What's up, Belzan? You just woke up. Nice. Yeah, the poison top hat. There's lots of items that I haven't finished. They've been in the game for a long time, but they just haven't been working. And so some of those items I'm going to work on next are the fire top hat. It lights enemies on fire. The ice top hat freezes enemies. The poison top hat poisons enemies. So there we got, this is diagonally moving. Projectiles, entities, any entity could have this. Diagonal movement now. It's private property. Oh, dang. You just nice. Jumped the barbed wire fence. Oh, dang. You're gonna start your new game? Cool, why not? A monocle weapon? Alter Blades. It's a really cool idea. Right? He's got a top hat. Why doesn't he have a monocle? Nobody knows yet. Great idea. All right, next I want the sound effect for the ice sword to be better. It's a flail. Oh, that makes sense. Oh, cool. Nice. I like that. Why not? All right. To do special. Oh, I got it, I got it. We could do launch ghost. We'll make separate noises for each one of these. Launch ice, launch fire, launch fear, Ghost, ice, oh, there's lightning as well. What other ghost swords are there? Ghost, fire, ice, lightning, poison. Oh, there's a poison sword? Wow. Okay, so all these are going to have separate sound effects. A visual Boolean logic gate simulator? Cool. Ah, yeah, totally, pizza. Right? So many swords, so little time. Input system. When we launch a ghost sword, we need to do a special sound effect. Running on the parent ID. Oh, wait, no, it's the shot ID. Never mind. Got a shot. Okay, so shot.profile.playsound. Wait, no. Profile. Live GDX jam? That's cool. I'm not on jam. WizJib. What's up, Baragia? Yeah, sorry the WizJib doesn't work on the little chat window you see up here in the top right. But it does work if you got Frankerfaces installed. So this is where we're going to play the sound launch ghost. Launch ice. Launch fire. They'll launch the lightning. All right, we're gonna need some other special. We need a poison one. Poison's gonna have its own like particle trail too. This is going to be launch poison. And the last one I think is fear. Fear sword. This doesn't have any special stuff. It probably should have its own particles. And we'll call that launch fear. So we got ghost, ice, fire, lightning, poison, fear. All right, now let's change one of them so we know that we're doing something right. So I'm gonna make launch the ice do a totally like fiery sound effect so it doesn't. Why you kill Wizjib? I didn't kill him. He's still there. It should work for y'all. Oh, it's a 30-day game jam? Wow, nice. Oh, yeah. Great. Okay, let's do another launch sound effect that's sort of icy. In fact, maybe just nothing. Yeah, one game a month. That's been around for a while. Let's get a really cool icy noise for this. already got some ice crackling and stuff like that, but I want to do maybe like ice breaking. So I can't use these ones with the dollar sign on them. This one could work. This one maybe. No. Okay, let's try this one that could work. It kind of sounds like bones, right? I'm thinking this little noise right there would be kind of good to start us off. Sound Bible? Haven't heard of that one. Oh, cool. It's like the same concept, right? Yeah. Sweet. I'll keep that one in mind. Token exhale. All right, I think this noise right here. I always want to make your sound effects mono for most of stuff. Most things should be mono. Mono, 16-bit, 50-50. Okay, let's try this out as a Ghost Sword launch. CI grip? Is that another one? Oh, the crunching noise is freaking you out. Sorry, man. Sorry about Oh, supposed to be something else. Was it BTTV that ruined it, huh? Thought it was a wooden plank. Yeah, I used to use Audacity. Back in the past, I would use that. Know. It's like lacking something. see what it sounds like if I mix in the old plasma launching sound effect. I think plasma launch was the sound. Trying to imagine what it would sound like if you had an icy sword and it launched a ghostly particle. Maybe sort of like breath, a breath noise. What's up, Pete and Wally? Oh my God, that's kind of good right there. Both these are good. I think it's from the same guy. Same person. Yeah, it does. Yeah, definitely. Wasn't quite happy with that at all. And the thing, you know, you start with an idea, and then when you try it out in the game, that's when you're like, that didn't work. So you gotta try something else. Oh, these are two different people. Released almost the same sound. Stream frozen? I don't know, maybe refresh? Let's see. Looks like, yeah, we're okay here on this end. That's the lower one. Ooh, yeah, this higher one is actually really nice for an icier noise. Oh yeah, definitely. No, I'm about to do that. I'm about to make it shorter. Yeah, I'm not gonna leave this whole sound effect in there for this ghost sword. The ghost sword launches for maybe one whole second is the maximum, you know, that the sound effect should be. So first thing I'm doing is making it mono, and then I'll play around with the timing and changing it up. So we've got quite an intro there. We don't need. Fade that in a little. And then this is a second. Let's try 2 seconds chopping it off there. We'll do a little bit of this kind of fade out. And I think it's a bit quiet for the game. What are we at? Negative 33 decibels. We can amplify that by at least 6. Whoa, not 48. Did I type 48? What the hell? Yeah, Born to Snipe. It already does have that kind of icy noise when it hits the enemies. So, just need to add something when it launches. That's pretty good. Let's try that out. Ice Sword, one. Overwrite. Oh no, don't be sorry, man. Thanks for suggesting. Always, yeah, always suggest things. Thank you, thank you. Oh, awesome! But it needs less intro, so I cut out some of that. Export this again. Yeah, sound quicker. That's what I was just doing there, making it the intro shorter. Like that. Yeah. That's awesome. That's so great. Sometimes the sound effect, yeah, it's definitely working brilliantly. Sometimes the sound effect does that. It just makes something so much better and awesomer. Okay, the next thing I'm gonna do is create an alternate version of this so we can kind of make it, a little more varied. So I'm gonna go, this is gonna be the Ice Sword 2. And this time I'm gonna add a little, I'm gonna shift it down a little bit or maybe up a little bit in its pitch. That's sounding too high now. Okay, I don't know if that's gonna sound good or not, so I'm gonna try it out as usual. I'm gonna save this as Ice Sword 2. 44, mono, 16. And add this as an alternate. So the way my engine works is I can specify extra noises like this. I create instead of playing one sound effect, it plays a randomly from an array. So we got Ice Sword 1 and 2, it can play. It just randomly chooses one at runtime, which one to play. Yeah, that's awesome. Even that just that one extra noise really helps the variation. Ghost swords are looking a lot better already. Awesome. Yes! That's awesome. Yay. How do I handle transitions? Is your whole map always loaded? No. For efficiency's sake, there's so many sprites in each area. In fact, there's something like sometimes there could be up to like 1,000 different entities in one room. So I have to let go of the old area. So what happens is the game is running on the current area. When a transition's about to happen, it creates the new area and then slides the camera. And then it lets go of the old area. So there's always only one area on screen. So that means it has to, If it goes back to a certain area and that area had stuff that it changed, like maybe there's blood on the ground or enemies that have died or whatever, it has to remember all those things. And so when it recreates that old area, like let's say you transition back to that one, it has to go create that new area, but remember all the things that changed, and then slide the camera again and let go of the old area once again. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's how the original Zelda works too. Merengue, yeah, I'm okay with having just two for now. I want to get on to working on a few of these other ones, like the fire, lightning, poison, fear. All these ones need some love as well. So I gotta love all of them. I can't just love one of these little ghost sword children. Yeah, let's focus on the fire one now. So I'm gonna comment out, or oh, we need the poison sword. Set that to zero. We also need the fear sword. So we got ghost, fire, lightning, ice, poison, fear. Now the ghost sword's awesome. We can focus on the fire sword a bit. Yeah, that's the original one even develops some. Come back to me, foot. So this one needs like a fiery launch noise, and also it needs way better particles. So we'll work on the animation first. Yeah, Merengue, I'm happy enough. I'm happy enough with two different variations. It's already got two, so it's already got some variation in it. And yeah, if I want to later on, I could go add two more and add four of them. I know, Born to Snipe, I do, right? But I just ate a banana. I don't get it. You never played Zelda? No, I definitely don't hate you or anything, man, but I'd really think if you're into that kind of genre, you should check it out. But if you're not into that kind of genre, don't even worry about it. Wet face. Wet. And we might as well do, let's call this one Fire Sword. Now I got that hooked up. And then in Enims, there's a special function for the Fire Sword particles. And all these, we want to make them bigger. Just like the ice. Here's the ice. Here's where it sets the scale bigger. In fact, we can go ahead and add this to all these. Lightning, fire, ice. That's all we got for now. Okay, so we're focusing on the fire. These ones are gonna have alternate colors too, but let's see what happened with some bigger. Sound Bible, flame arrow. Cool. Cool, same noise, nice. So with this effect, I want these to not be additive. Want these to be colored. And adding some randomness to the X and Y as well. So drandf times at least two. And this is where we want to do three different colors, and each time Each time it chooses a different random color for these particles. Oh, I don't even need that. RGB. Okay, so I need the three colors of fire. Let's look those up. Divine Quad Dawn. Yo, any level designers here? I have a question. I'm sure there's some level designers in here. Where's fire? Fire. There it is. Fire. Here's the first color, yellowy. Second color is going to be an orangey. Third color is that reddish one. Well, it's still, I guess it's dark orange. What did I do wrong? There we go. Okay, so there. We'll just randomly select one of those colors. You just woke up in those lands and saw that cave. Yeah, we're all game devs here, man. Quad on. What you need? Divine Quadon, what do you need help with, man? What's your question? Link's Awakening than the original, huh? Alright. I think I need to capture colors. Maybe I do. Oh, it doesn't like that. Why can't you capture? Colors cannot be captured because it doesn't have automatic storage duration. I think I can still access colors. I think there's a random element function. There it is, random element. Oh, I don't like that. All right, there. So now we should have an orange, yellow, and darker orange when we fire this ghost sword. So what is essential to creating an immersive game world such as a small town? I have a tree and buildings, you know, the basics, but is there anything else to amp it up? Dude, there's tons. What about wind? Do you have wind? Is wind affecting things? Do you have your trees swaying in the wind? Do you have rain? Maybe rain would be cool. Right? Think of nature and just do stuff that makes your game look animated. Oh, I lost the sword already. I thought Zelda was perfect. Have you seen the screen scroll glitch from Zelda 1? Oh, and they need to not be opaque. This is fade out. What? What is it? These should be. Oh, I guess they're fading out over the entire lifetime. Okay. try fading out only half the lifetime. Yeah, there you go. Vegetation, ponds, lakes, weather, NPCs, totally. That's looking better. All right, great. Let's do a sound effect now. Check out the sound effect. Merengue was siren. Well, that's kind of cool. But a little too high. I mean, yeah, nah, it's too high. Sounds like it was really, large fireball. That's kind of cool. I guess I gotta save this link. Oh yeah, moving for sure with NPCs. Okay, it looks like this, did it say, yeah, it saved the URL. That's great. I want that so I can attribute this person later on. This is kind of a not that great a quality of noise, but all right, Jules. Good night, man. Thanks, man. Have a good one. Really abrupt ending right at the end of this. This trail is bad. So if I just make it like that a little bit, or like actually more like this, clean up that ending. Oh, I wish it had more. Oh, that's okay. Good enough to try. Large. Oh, it's an MP3. That's why it sounds so low quality. All right, let's put this in raw waves. Mono 16, fire sword 1, and let's see how it sounds. It looks like this might be the last sword I can do too. What do we have for time? Yeah, we're already over time. Okay. This is gonna be the last sword for today. Okay, it's got way too long of an intro. Still sounds delayed. What's going on with that? In input system, when it creates this whole shot and everything, I think it delays a sec. Oh, E dot attack dot delay. Yeah, I guess I just have to really tone down the intro. What do the bomb animations look like? I'll show you some bombs. Gotta get some bombs first. Bomb, 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 bomb! 8 bombs! Gotta make sure I have a bomb container though. Or else it'll think I'm an imposter. I got four bomb container ones. Bombs look like. And that's another item I need to work on. There's fire bombs, poison bombs, fear bombs, there's lots of different bombs, so. Oh man, lost all my health already. I need to program a button that gives you full health in debug mode. Now it sounds just right. Sweet. I love it. Let's add a variation. Thanks, Zed Epsilon. Cheers, man. Yeah, there's gonna be more. There's gonna be a lot more bombs. Types of bombs. There's not only there are going to be different types of bombs for the regular bomb, but there's going to be mini bombs, there's going to be mines, and maybe super bombs, kind of like a la Metroid. Alright, once again, I'm going to play with pitching it down a little, or up a little. Actually sounds alright, keep that. Save this as Fire Sword 2. You know what? Sound design is almost as important as art. In fact, it might be as important as art. Your sound effects can make or break a weapon. If you guys seen that article on like how in Quake, or I think it was Wolfenstein actually, in Wolfenstein there was a certain gun which didn't have as good of a sound effect as the other gun, but it had exactly the same stats as another gun. And people, by far, chose not to use that other gun because it didn't have as good of a sound effect. So sound effects can really impact your whole game. So, something to keep in mind. All right, so we've got launch fire. Let's turn this into a variations. See what it sounds like with those two variations. Nukes. Yes, black marks on the ground. Totally Scottish pizza. Good idea. Very great idea. Yeah, bomb. Okay, when I work on bombs, definitely do that. Maybe tomorrow. If I'm streaming tomorrow, I might stream tomorrow. So yeah, everybody that's watching the stream here, I'm about to shut her down for the day. I do stream 5 days a week or so, sometimes up to 7 days a week. I'm always streaming about this time, but I'm never quite consistent. So if you wanna follow my streams, you can click the follow button or whatever, and that'll give you notifications when I'm live. Yeah, my name's Nathaniel. I go by WizardFoo. This game is called Songbringer. It's like Zelda 1. And I'm working on the Ghost Sword today. It's this little fiery thing which you launch at people. Nice, I'm loving it. Okay, so that's it for today. You guys, I'll check you next time. Have a good day, everybody.